Welcome back to 17 On Set. Drunk driving is an issue we devote extensive coverage to here on KGET. We've dubbed the issue Kern's Sober Reality. Kern County ranks worst in the state for DUI crashes resulting in injuries and second most in the United States. Joining us this morning to tell us more about Walk Like Mad, the event coming up this weekend, and share a personal story about the consequences of drunk driving, Mary Jo Kaznicka and Michael George. Thank you both so much for coming in this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
So Mary Jo, I'd just like to start with you and just ask you really quickly if you want to tell us a little bit about your daughter and what happened in 2014.
She and two of her best friends were on their way home from a Blaze baseball game, and it was the end of summer. They all worked for Kern School's Federal Credit Union and just bonded, and they'd been given tickets by a member of the group to be able to go to the game, and again, just celebrating. It was one of the girls' birthdays recently, so they wanted to just go out and have a good time, and they were on their way home, and not far from home. They see a lot of these accidents happen so close to home. Each of them was about a mile away from home, Jackie driving, and they were hit by a drunk driver. Came up behind them at over 100 miles per hour when the girls were dead stopped at a red light. And unfortunately, two of them, their lives were taken, and the third one, Jessica, survived. And she's had to live and will for the rest of her life with the memories, with emotional scars, physical scars. But our daughter was a mom. She was just a wonderful human being, as was mm-hmm. Pavinder Clare, who was also, her life was also taken. And it's impacted us from that day forward, changed our lives forever.
The victims in these crashes aren't just the people in the vehicles. It extends so much further into our communities. Yeah.
Exactly. It's a complete ripple effect, and you never know exactly how far-reaching it is until something like this happens mm-hmm. to you. And that was our first response was, no, it didn't happen. No, we don't believe you when the sheriff comes to your home. And then it was, well, why us? Why? Why did this happen? It's a question that'll never be answered, but it's one that can be changed. And that's what I found through the MAD organization, is this is the number one preventable, totally yes. preventable thing that could happen. And my husband, when we were told about this, he said, we were told that there was an accident. And he's the one who said that these are not accidents. People have a choice when they get behind the wheel impaired, and every one of them can make the choice to not do that, and that's why it's not an accident. An accident involves something that's non-committal. These people make a conscious decision to do this.
And we have so many of these happening in Kern County, yeah. which is just heartbreaking because you never know which family is going to be affected next. So this weekend is not just for victims and people who've been affected by drunk driving crashes. It's for the entire community to come out and get behind this issue and finding a way to stop.